Hi all,
I'm Nathan, this is Laura.
Hi, this video has a couple of Lindt or Lindor chocolate products that we have reviewed in the past over on what is now our toy channel. They're more at home here on our food review channel, of course, so enjoy.
I'm here with my mustachio wife, Laura.
I'm here with my smooth husband, Nathan.
And we're here for some new Lindt Lindor new pistachio, irresistibly smooth pistachio chocolate balls.
Yes. So these are the Lindor chocolate balls. It looks like milk chocolate to me.
Yep.
With the filling, the nice creamy, smooth filling is pistachio flavoured this time.
And they say nothing on the back or anything about them.
They usually don't.
No.
It's pistachio and that's what it is.
Alright.
Now, Nathan has something to say about what's in the description
below.
Oh,
yes, we have links to our Facebook and Instagram for all updates and sneak peeks.
And
a link to our new channel, Colour Doos, where we do lots of kits and Australian things and all fun sorts.
Arts and craft kits, by the way.
Yes.
Like colouring and things like that. There's a couple of videos up already and more to come.
Oh, it feels a bit sweaty. Being under these lights has not done them any favours.
We're also still in summer here in Australia, or just outside of summer, so it's still quite hot. Looks good, though.
Mmm.
Oh, it really smells like pistachio. Yeah.
Doesn't really taste like it, though.
Mmm. It does.
It's very light in the flavour.
Mmm.
Yeah, a little bit in the middle, and there's just regular Lindt chocolate takeover for me.
Mm. I got, the smell hit me. And then when I kind of got into the middle, there was a sudden pistachio, but then it was gone. Just sort of, very, very mild. I could have definitely used a bit more oomph in that, I think, because I really love pistachios.
I think I like the Christmas versions. They have like the mints and candy canes like better than
they
these
were really personally. Nice. I mean, these are nice and smooth and tasty, don't get me wrong.
Because Lindt chocolate, you know, nice in general. But, the pistachio flavouring in it's a bit weak.
Mmm. I kind of have a small aftertaste of it, maybe. But maybe I'm just imagining it. But it's still nice. Mm. Just not strong enough, I don't think.
So good if you like a little bit of pistachio, but not too much. And if you hate pistachio, you're probably still not going to like it.
No, because it still does taste like it. If you enjoyed watching this video, give us a thumbs up. Let us know down below if you're a pistachio eater, or if not, what's your favourite nut?
Yours is cashews.
Actually, my favourite nut's pistachios, Nathan.
I thought you really like cashews as
well. I do like cashews, but pistachios are my favourite.
Is it because it rhymes with mustachio?
No.
I'm here with my... It's not easy being green wife, Laura.
I'm here with my tea-toting husband, Nathan.
And we're here. Is it that time of year? Is it almost Christmas? Is it almost time for another limited edition Lindor that has no relation to Christmas?
I was going to say, what? This has nothing to do with Christmas. It just happens to be green. And apparently, Nathan had Christmas on the brain.
It's matcha.
Yeah, which is green tea, for those who have never tried it before. And this is a new flavour of Lindor chocolate balls.
Now, I will mention this at the start. If you see it in the store and you have an interest in it, buy it. Last year, actually for Christmas, they brought out a gingerbread flavour.
Which was delicious.
I saw it once on store shelves, and I never saw it again for the entire holidays, and it was gone. So, obviously...
They're obviously pretty popular.
It's got nothing about the actual specific flavour.
It's matcha. I assume they're guessing that people know what it is. Hopefully, most do.
Did you say what they were?
Matcha? Green tea?
There you go.
And they're in white chocolate, as you can see on the front of the pack.
Mm.
Look, I'll be honest, white chocolate, not my favourite. But I do like green tea matcha flavoured stuff. So, I'm hoping that this will be nice.
Ooh.
So green.
That's really matchery.
Mmm.
Goes well together with the white chocolate, though.
Mmm. That's nice.
Because it sort of flavours the white chocolate.
Mmm. I don't... Sorry. I didn't get a lot of white chocolate, like, taste.
None.
It went really nicely with the filling, which is very heavy on the matcha. But
it's very smooth. It is heavy on the matcha.
So it is. It's smooth but strong.
If you don't like that flavour, this is definitely not going to change your mind.
No, but if you're not a huge fan of white chocolate but you like the matcha, I think you could still go for that because I don't like white chocolate.
It's a really nice combination together, provided you have an interest in both the flavours.
Well, yeah. Like I said, I don't like white chocolate, and I still thought that was nice because of the strong filling. So
it's not easy being green.
don't know why you keep saying that. Yeah, really nice. I recommend it. And like Nathan said, pick it up before it disappears, just in case it does.
Just in
Might
case.
Not, but who knows.
Mm.
If you enjoyed watching this video, give us a thumbs up. Let us know down below which has been your favourite flavour of filling in the Lindt ball, or your favourite block of Lindt chocolate. Let us know.
They have quite a few now.
Yeah, they really do. They've expanded a lot.
I'm here with my It's That Time of Year Again wife, Laura.
I'm here with my Christmassy husband, Nathan.
And we're here for some more Lindt Lindor Limited Edition chocolate balls.
Yes, we have two different flavours for the Christmas this year. We've got the milk and white and the peppermint cookie flavour. Both are limited, as you said, but there's also the gingerbread flavour from last year's Christmas out as well.
Which we have on our channel, maybe.
Which we have on what was our food channel at the time last year. So there's a link on, I think, our like our main YouTube page. If you want to go check that out, but we're not publishing over there anymore.
So,
hint, they were yummy.
They were delicious. We actually got some more this year we ate off camera. They don't sound as interesting as the gingerbread. I think that's just going to sort of meld together, and I think that's just going to taste like a peppermint chocolate with like crunchy bits in it.
Well, yeah, that's probably what they're going for. So let's try the milk and the white. So it's like their white mousse type filling with milk chocolate outside. I mean, I think it'll be nice, but
you want to share one or have one each? Let's have one each. It'd be a bit weird trying to.
I do like the wrapper. Just feel free to open yours, but they have little like snowmen. Hey, was your snowman different? Or is that just my imagination? Maybe your snowman's different. Oh, cool. Yeah, really nice packaging. Happy with that.
There you go. Chocolate on the outside, white chocolate on the inside.
Mm-hmm.
Very rich.
Mm. Nice, though.
It is nice.
Mm.
I know you're not a big fan of white chocolate.
The white inside, though, is more like a white sort of mousse rather than just white chocolate, like pure white chocolate. So,
and it does meld in nicely with the regular chocolate.
It really does. It's a nice balance.
It is very smooth. They don't lie.
They certainly do not. I really like that. And I'm surprised. Like you said, white chocolate, not really my choice, but
you don't get left with a really half taste aftertaste in your mouth. It's just very mellow.
It's smooth. It's nice. It mixes well. Yum. Definitely something you could put out Christmas Day, and I think they would disappear.
Yes. I got these two particular packs at Big W in Australia.
But they do have them presumably at like Woolworths and Coles.
I think I've seen them there too, but
I haven't gone looking for them, so.
Come on.
Usually they're available there. And pretty much everywhere.
Yeah.
To be honest. Anywhere that sells Lindt
chocolate. They've gotten really big with their different flavours in the last couple of years.
Which is fun.
It is fun.
All right, again, I really like the packaging. It's got like the stripy sort of, you know, peppermint candy sort of look.
Oh, it smells pepperminty.
Yeah. Okay.
So it's literally just like a mousse.
Ooh, it does have that smell, doesn't it?
That's very strong.
Hmm.
What are those biscuits? The round ones, they're quite flat, like mint flavoured.
Like an after dinner mint.
Peppermint cookies. Cadbury peppermint cookies, I think.
Mm-hmm.
Tastes very similar to those. Mm.
Yeah. It's actually quite strong. Those lollies.
The hard ball.
You know, those ones, yeah, that are really, really super minty. That is what tastes like is in there. They're like little ground up bits. Mm. Although it's not that crunchy, but it's that definitely that flavour. Like this isn't like normal peppermint flavour. This is like Christmas peppermint lolly flavour. Yeah, that makes sense.
It is. There is a difference if you try them side by side.
I don't really get the cookie per se.
I get the cookie crunches and all that. I really do.
But crunch could have just been the mint. I mean, I wouldn't have known.
It's either a peppermint mint or a peppermint patty. I can't remember what it is, but it's a Cadbury like round biscuit, and it tastes very, very similar to it. Let me know if you know what I'm talking about. I'm not going crazy, I promise.
I don't buy a lot of mint stuff. Look, I have a couple of mint things I like, and that's about it.
If you like what you see, the, you know, peppermint cookie, chocolate, go for it. You're going to like it. If you're like, I'm not sure about the peppermint, do not try it. It lasts forever. It's rich and it's very, it's very strong.
So here's what I would say. I think this would work well as an after dinner mint. You know, after your Christmas dinner.
Cleanse the palate off all the turkey and jelly
little,
and all that.
Little special treat at the end. Whereas this one is more of a, yeah, don't mind if I have a little sweet treat for Christmas. You know, like,
yeah.
I think they have their place. If you enjoyed watching this video, give us a thumbs up. Let us know down below what sort of sweet treats you're going to be having this Christmas. Do you go for chocolates or do you just have more like big desserts like, you know, pavlova pudding, that sort of thing?
Or do you just keep on going for the savoury chicken and things and leftovers?
Maybe. Press that subscribe button.
Sounds good.
Thanks for watching.
Bye-bye.